We have loads of ideas on what to do next.
Yes.
Which I'm not allowed to tell you.
Are you sure? Are you, a little bit? I'm not going to tell anyone. No. Stefan, it's time to get technical.
Yeah.
I need you to tell me about this PK250.
Yep, pleasure.
I'm ready for it. Give it all to me.
Okay, here he comes. So, PK250 tech.
Yes.
First crane out of the updated new tech range.
Okay.
25 ton meter lifting capacity.
Yeah.
Comes with a reach of 19 meters.
Yeah.
With a fly chip almost 24 meters, which is the longest reach in its class, and comes as an endless slewing crane, like continuous rotation,
yes,
or with a rack and pinion slewing system, depending on the customer's job, depending on the customer's application. I think design is a very important topic, but it's not just, we're not just doing it for the sake of design, but we're also doing it to make people understand that this is a crane that has new features.
Okay.
And these features based on a new control system, which is Paltronic 180.
Yes.
That is a new computing unit that has additional power, so we can add new safety systems, assistance systems.
Okay, and tell me about how this is powered. Is electrification involved in this? How is this powered?
Yeah, so this is also a very interesting concept because the size, the 25 ton meter range in the back is mounted on an electric, fully electric chassis.
Fully electric?
On a fully electric Volvo FE chassis.
Okay.
But it still runs on conventional hydraulics.
Because I'm listening here, this crane is operating behind me and I can't hear anything.
Yep.
Yeah, which is very strange. I'm used to hearing the revs, revs way up on the truck.
Yes, so of course, yeah.
Talk to me about energy consumption.
Yeah.
So how much energy is the crane actually using?
That's a very good point, because there is, at this moment of time, it seems that there is lots of horror stories out there that cranes would suck all the batteries empty because
that would be my worry, yes. Yeah.
No, it's definitely not the case. What we know is that an average crane application during a day would take off less than 15 kilowatt hours. And 15 kilowatt hours on that truck behind us is about 8% of the total capacity. So if you're sitting on a traffic light, standing on a traffic light, and you use the electric power of your truck, you use much more energy than we are consuming over an entire day.
So tell me a little bit more about the assist features on this and what I can expect to see more at Bauma.
What we have here is, first of all, let me start with the memory position, which is brand new. And you can save four positions, You go somewhere with a boom tip.
Yes.
You press save. You go somewhere else, and it will find exactly that spot by pressing one lever.
Wow! Give me an example of the application we could use that in.
If you have, let's say, talking about roofing.
Yeah.
So there is this certain spot where you bring, or let's say, bricks and blocks.
Yes.
There is this certain position where you actually unload your bricks.
Yes.
So this is what you save it.
Yes.
You go back, you probably even save the position somewhere close to your truck.
Yes.
And you let go the crane in between these two positions, and maybe you only do the precision work in the end yourself. So you would still have to watch it.
Yep.
And you would release the lever and it would stop.
Okay.
So this is it's kind of a deadman switch.
So your hand needs to be on the lever?
Your hand needs to be on one lever.
Okay, so you can't just set it and then just put your hands behind your back.
No. We're not there. This is the future, for sure. Like, this is fully autonomous, but we are not there.
A delivery that would take 45 minutes could now maybe take 25, 30 minutes, basically.
Yeah, could be, yeah.
And you could possibly try and do an extra job a day.
Yep.
Fantastic.
That's the idea. And when it comes to autonomy functions, this is the beginning. So we are working ourselves in there. So we have loads of ideas on what to do next.
Yes.
Which I'm not allowed to tell you.
Are you sure? Are you, a little bit? I'm not going to tell anyone.
No.
And this is the first step.
And then we also have the smart control feature.
Yes.
Which is, to me, my most favorite feature today, because it really helps to get a new driver trained at the job within a very short period of time.
Yes.
That is really something that supports him in the job, makes his life easier. Yeah, this is what is supported by tech, and this is also what tech stands for, as we've been talking before. Leveling assistant is something that that will be introduced on Bauma. Autonomous leveling of the chassis.
You mean with this, with the support?
Yep. You say? With the support legs. Yes, that's a job that you have to carry out today, manual.
Okay.
And in future, this will be done by the system itself.
And we'll get to see that at Bauma.
Yep.
That I'm looking forward to. I won't tell anyone.